Welcome everybody. Okay. Welcome everybody. My name is Bas van Essens, as mentioned. It's a very special opportunity for me to represent the Dutch government over here. So I started a brief to shortly my introduction, who I am, and my ambitions and beliefs. And I gave a little bit context about the organization, Rijkswaterstaat or RWS. And then I'm going to start the adventure we're having right now, and which we started 2 years ago, and we're in the middle of it. I'm the head of the Department of Information Development, and soon I'm going to be responsible for setting up a lab in Rijkswaterstaat. That's going to be my next job role. I have several roles within the Royal Netherlands Air Force, also within Rijkswaterstaat, from business management to ICT to data job roles. My main beliefs are societal engagement and self-supporting organizations, because I think that's a trending topic. Let's take it back to our home, where people are investing in solar systems on their roofs and getting their own vegetable gardens to be self-supporting and not be dependent about our organizations. So I think organizations are getting there as well. So this is to be a software-driven, data-driven company. This is necessary to get in the right mindset. Inspiring words for me are innovation and continuously learning. And also, not a very important thing in business is happy customers. And that's a real inspiration for me to develop new beautiful things for Rijkswaterstaat. A little bit context about the organization, Rijkswaterstaat. Does anybody know Rijkswaterstaat? Yes, I have a few fans. Good. It's the infrastructure company of infrastructure government of the Netherlands, and we are responsible for roads, waterways, tunnels, dikes, everything you can imagine by infrastructure. And we're also delivering the traffic management. And as you can see on the illustration behind me, it's a very complex infrastructure, and it's also complex by the IT. That is controlling and supporting the infrastructure. Okay, this is about a little bit context. Now the adventure or story starts. What I thought when I started this whole thinking about ecosystems, I thought, what is Rijkswaterstaat about? What's our responsibilities? And then we had the idea to develop a society plan 2.0. Okay, what's this the organization needs to be self-supporting, and what ecosystem do we need to develop? Our government's task is to be transparent, agile, and affordable. Very pleased for our civilians. Then several developments were already going in our organization. We had already the ICE strategy. Our CEO, Perry van der Weijden, when he came to our organization, the first thing he did was develop an ICE strategy. And that gives focus for the next couple of years. And we also had a program about attitude and behavior. It's called Lean. Kracht, we did our own word for it. And that was about, okay, improving every day. And it's got to be inside of the people. And be together with others. We can't do everything by our own. And there was our gardener who said, okay, for the CIO agenda 2016, you realize you have to develop a digital agenda about thinking about platforms. Those things together, and also the buzzwords, DevOps, bimodal, agile, being cloud native, all those things together, realize that, okay, this is very important that we are developing an ecosystem in which everything is connected, from business to platform to talent, to partnerships and everything we need to survive in this area. I could talk about it like 15 minutes, but also can show you a little movie about 1 minute that is going to explain everything that we need for our ecosystem within Rijkswaterstaat. So sit back and relax. It's going very fast, but I'm very excited about this movie. So enjoy.
It's the government's task to organize our society in a transparent, flexible, and affordable manner. Automation is an increasingly important aspect of that task. Unfortunately, automation often goes wrong. Rijkswaterstaat has proven that it's possible to do it right. They work independently within an ecosystem. Let us examine this ecosystem based on Gartner's five platforms: business, leadership, talent, delivery, and technical. Business. Based on transactions and data, the business draws up the automation assignment coherently. This creates involvement and guarantees ownership. Leadership. Rijkswaterstaat uses the program Kracht. One Rijkswaterstaat. Better every day, together with others. And the I strategy. Based on standardization and reuse. Talent. Committed professionals do the work, within and outside the organization. They make Rijkswaterstaat independent, agile and flexible. Sound agreements reinforce the partnership. Various disciplines work together in small development teams, in which the combination of the team members varies per assignment. By linking the assignment to the used platforms during an intake, the team can be configured. Delivery. Support is provided by SAP, Mendix, Spring, SAS, and SharePoint. Based on user stories, a prototype is rapidly created. The business tests the prototype. Next, the application goes live, after which business intelligence makes it possible to measure and manage in real time. Technical. With Pivotal Cloud Foundry's platform as a service, every solution can be offered quickly and aligned with other solutions. Using infrastructure as a service, the hardware is virtualized in the Rijkscloud for better availability and reliability. The Apps Manager makes the PaaS layer easy to manage. In short, by keeping in mind the entire organization, it is possible to automate independently, flexibly, and successfully, within an ecosystem in which everything is connected and where everyone can take responsibility at the right moment.
Cool movie, eh? Too good to be true. You were probably asking, is this guy from the RWS or from Disneyland telling us fairy tales over here? That is actually the situation and actually the way of work we're doing right now. We started, we're developing it every time, every day, and we're improving it also every day. And the main, zoom in a little bit on a few slides that are really key success factors of this whole concept. We started with, formerly we did IT solutions, and then we're going to build and develop IT solutions without involving the business. And we, when we were ready, the IT business said, okay, this is going to use, and the users very safe life with you, and good luck. The new thing of thinking is involving the business like product owner. The business is in charge of delivering the right user stories, and we have two methods about it, and we combine them a lot. It's about the process, because we had a big reorganization a few years ago, and everybody was to be focused on the new process to work in, only the applications didn't change. So people were a little bit like a ghost within our own organization. So we had to get rid of the legacy and rationalize all the applications to the platforms. But we also had to get rid of the inefficiency of the processes. So, and this helps a lot to getting to get this digital transformation going. So within workshops, together with business, we looked at the process they are responsible for. We took out of the inefficiency, and then we put it to a digital transformation on the platforms we are using, as mentioned in the movie. There's also a data side of it. Because of hypotheses and data sources, we are going to make these apps being smarter, and that is going to help the business to survive in the environment they are at the moment. Another thing that we set up was the pizza factory, as we call it. Not to eat, but to work. The whole idea is that because we had to transform our organization And so we have to make mixed teams with resources from the departments. We're going to mix it with the development teams. And when they're ready, the services will be back to the organization of the department who is responsible and do the maintenance about it. So this whole idea of pizza teams is small teams, 6 to 8 people. And based on the user stories we're having, we're going to select the available platforms, the standard platforms we are using. And we already had a lot of building blocks. It's already in the App Store of our organization. And every time we have a user story, we're going to see, okay, have we already made some organization or organization or building blocks, and can we reuse it for this user story? As I said, we're going to check, we have an intake board. This intake board is going to check what is the user story and what do we need. That leads to a selection of the platforms we're going to use, SAS, Mendix, Spring, whatever. And the platform selection also leads to our team configuration, like developers, UX, security, ops guys, infra guys who are going to be responsible for the PCF delivery. And together, they are responsible for delivering the app agilely. The whole idea of platform thinking was the more users, the higher return is on the platform. Because we are a big organization and we can't develop all our software by our own. So we developed also a partner idea, because all our system integrators and all other guys who wants to develop on apps for services or solutions for our organization, we also invite them to together work on this development. So let's take an example. We have made SAM. It's an application that is for civilians when there's something on the road, or they want to ask about something about slices or whatever. This is a contact customer center application. And let's see this from the bottom up, to the platform to users. We use the platforms, the selection. Then we build a product on it called case management, because we can reuse it for other applications. Then we build a service on it, managing customer requests. That's the service we're going to deliver to our civilians. And the solution we built was the application SAM. And the more users we are having on this application, on this platform, the higher return is on the platform. Other partners can also be developing on this way. We are delivering the standard platforms, as mentioned below, and those can develop products, services, and solutions for Rijkswaterstaat also, with the 12-factor app as a constraint. Now I'm going to show you an example of an application we have made. It's also a movie, also very short, and then you can see all those platforms together, how they manage it to develop a new app for the business, for the customer care center. Here it is.
Rijkswaterstaat receives hundreds of alerts and questions every day from citizens, employees, and businesses. Alerts about ducks on the road, the operating hours of locks, accommodating a new colleague. In order to deal with each alert quickly and effectively, Rijkswaterstaat uses SUM, a smart registration system for alerts. SUM is incident-based. This enables members of staff to deal with one alert at a time in one central system, even if they work in different regions or services. This makes collaboration a lot easier. Take the example of accommodating a new colleague. A single alert itemizes all the relevant actions, and everyone can easily follow developments. SUM also allows us to help our customers more effectively and to deal with their questions more quickly. SUM's reports also provide insights. Through which channels do most alerts arrive? Or where do alerts get stuck in the organization? This information enables us to constantly improve. Moreover, we continue to develop SUM together with the end users. Improvements can be swiftly implemented. Lastly, SUM has been quality tested and is inexpensive to install. SUM supports both effective collaboration and fast solutions. allowing Reichswaffenstaat to fulfill its mission. Better every day.
Now you can say, okay, nice application, whatever. But the idea of this application was, okay, we did it in a few hours, 2,000 hours. We developed it together with our business. And now we are seeing that we are handling about 13,000 alerts and questions each month. And we did, it's available for all of our employees of Rijkswaterstaat. This model we are using in this application, we're also going to share with other government parts, and they are organizations, and they are going to share this model with other organizations. So we're going to make us very smart together, and when we share, we can multiply our models, and so you don't have to invest every time in the same systems, because all the governments have shared organizations, like communication, HR, finance. And so when we are developing a model for supporting this process, we share it with them, and they also make it better, and then together we make better affordable for our taxpayers. What I said, development hours, prototype was within a month, ready to use 7 months. It wasn't the development time, but it was to get the change ready by the business. It was a really massive impact, and we have to get the programs and the technique was already ready, but the business needed it to adopt the changes we had to make. I don't know if you know the software improvement group. Is anybody familiar with it? This gives the quality of the software, and our application is 4 stars out of 5. So when it is really rapidly developed, it also has a high quality of software. And also, what I said, low cost. And direct deployment, because it was the first application we did also with Cloud Foundry. And we bought Cloud Foundry in December, first week of December. The third week, we had it up and running, and also was the first application in production. So that was really cool, cool development. What I said, we based on process models. This is an actor and a transaction scheme we are using to develop this application. It's just have a quick view on it. And then the application itself, to give a little bit illustration about, okay, well, how does the application look? On one side, you have the caseload. It was a non-functional request. They also wanted to get all the data they need by the job role was within the system on one screen, easily to manage. And then there was a connector to SAS, who are geographically gives the alerts on, in this example, on the highway. And you can see we have 93 incidents on that highway, which is connected to the system that we built. So this is really cool. And the nice part, we have the apps manager, my favorite tool, althans. you can easily manage to scale up or whatever, and you also can do automated scaling. And there was the first application that we used with auto scaling, and now every time we get a nice alert when there's downscaling or upscaling. So this is really cool. The benefits. We are all, I don't know how it is in your organization, we have a lot of discussion about architecture, and with the installing Cloud Foundry, we had a standard architecture, so we had a lot of less discussions about what is the right architecture to use, and we can save money about the personnel, and we can allocate personnel better, so, and resource into other projects. So there's a lot of saving, but also a lot of benefits on the architecture side. As I said, it was scalable and enabling reuse, so we can easily manage that on the background. Supports important for us is the process-driven and data-driven approach where we are using our development, our app development. And we're all connected in one ecosystem, and as I mentioned in the movie, everything has to be connected to get the change ready within the business, to adopt the business change, and also get the right equipment or, well, the technical platforms. Right in time. I want to thank you about letting me talk and letting me share my story about Rijkswaterstaat. And if you have any questions, please mail or whatever you want to do, or call me. And let's discuss afterwards this meeting. Thank you.